The Electric Vehicle Association of the Philippines strengthens ties with Chinese EV manufacturers to boost industry cooperation. EVAP visited the office of the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Industry Cooperation Committee in China that was back in July. There, the two groups agreed to collaborate in accelerating the adoption of EVs and exchanging knowledge and expertise. They also discussed a possible collaboration in the sector among industry players in East Asia and the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN. Amid sticky inflation, motorists and some lawmakers are banding together to block toll fee hikes. Alvin El Chico tells us more.
A number of motorists have supported the call to suspend any pending increase in toll rates for expressways nationwide. Senators Rafi Tulfo and Sherwin Gatchalian asked the Toll Regulatory Board to block the toll fee hike until tollway operators improve service to motorists.
Yung pagtaas po kasi ng mga toll fee po, eh pandagdag na lang din po ng gasolina namin.
Sa ibang bansa naman, marami ng systems in place na hindi na nga kailangan yung barrier, hindi na kailangan ng RFID, the plate number should suffice.
Even the group of truckers support the halt in toll fee increases.
Yung mga dating issue natin sa kanila, na problema natin sa kanila, katulad ng mga RFID nila na sablay-sablay, ganun pa rin, mas lalo pa nga lumala.
But it remains unclear which tollways have pending rate hike as the Toll Regulatory Board kept mum about this information.
Itong TRB, hindi nila ginagawa yung kanilang trabaho dahil yung key performance index, itong mga dapat sinisugurado nilang magandang serbisyo, hindi nila ginagawa.
The North Luzon Expressway says it has no more pending toll hike in the next months, but the NLEX Connector Road from Caloocan to Manila has a pending application to adjust the toll. This elevated tollway charges 86 pesos from Caloocan to Magsaysay Boulevard, though the rate is only from Caloocan to España Boulevard. Gatchalian admits he is not confident about TRB's promise to suspend any toll hike.
Hindi malinaw na pangako, no? Kasi ang sabi, idadalim pa sa board. Pero kami, talagang desidido kami na pigilan itong pagtaas hanggang maayos itong tinatawag nating key performance index.
The Metro Pacific Tollways Corporation, which operates NLEX and other major toll roads, admits there are issues to be resolved, but the main goal is to eventually remove the barriers and toll booths and ensure interoperability of RFID.
Ibig sabihin, pumasok ka San Miguel, pumasok ka sa NLEX, iisa na lang yung load mo, isa na lang yung wallet mo, hindi ka pareho ngayon, maglo-load ka sa dalawa. Isa na lang yan by October 1.
But as these projects are being completed, the MPTC says toll adjustments should not be stopped.
Sana wag naman sa lahat.
Mm-hmm.
Kung saan lang may problema, sige, di kami mag-English dyan. Gaya nun, doon sa Espanya at saka sa Magsaysay. 10 buwan na yon na gumagana, napapagamit sa publiko. Hinihintay namin yung English. Yun, madidelay pa ba yun?
Operators of other tollways have not issued any statement regarding the issue. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
Marine and weather experts from the U.S. arrive in the Philippines to lend a hand as the country battles 3 oil spills. 8 experts from the U.S. Coast Guard and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration will help recover the sunken and grounded ships leaking oil in parts of Luzon. Oil extraction for MTKR Terra Nova has yet to begin, with divers still putting metal caps on the pressure valves of the ships. The process is expected to be completed within a week.
Kasi pag nag-siphon tayo, di ba, nagkakaroon ng vibration yun. Eh. Tapos nagkakaroon ng vacuum. Ang iniingatan natin, baka mag-release yung mga valve na yun. Kaya mahalaga yun, tatakpan muna namin. Sisecure muna namin sa nawag gagalaw. Then after that, safe na tayo magsipuning.
Meanwhile, the province of Bataan once again put under a state of calamity, this time due to the effects of the oil spill. The province also suffering from the typhoon-enhanced southwest monsoon last month. Now, following the devastation from Typhoon Carina and the enhanced monsoon that followed, the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority says government is now crafting a 50-year drainage master plan for Metro Manila. The MMDA says the master plan covers upgrades and expansions to the region's drainage network. And aside from this, the MMDA plans to construct new pumping stations, flood tunnels, and small water impounding projects, among others. Although welcomed, some senators question the length of time it would take to complete the projects. Metro Manila was placed under a state of calamity last month due to the massive flooding which killed more than 40 in the country. Despite consensus and earlier telegraphing an August easing, the central bank governor now says a rate cut is less likely in the near term. That's his words. That's after July's inflation print picked up to breach government's target range. Lady Vicentia reports.
The Philippines Monetary Board may keep interest rates steady at its policy meeting next week. That's after headline inflation shot up last July to 4.4%, the highest level so far this year.
A little bit less likely kasi mataas yung ano eh, inflation eh, but we have to look at other numbers. 4.4, may kasamang base effect yan na 0.3. So without the base effect, it's really 4.1. Which is still worse than expected, but not that much, not that bad, no? Kasi na-breach lang ng konti yung ceiling.
For Nomura economist Yuben Paracuelles, the BSP may still cut rates on August 15th by 25 basis points.
It's not just about the inflation outlook becoming much more favorable and the risks are now coming to the downside because of some of these policy responses that I talked about. But importantly, we've seen what's happened in the U.S. And the Fed becoming a bit more decisively dovish. And I think it really opens the window for BSP to start looking into removing some of that restrictedness on the monetary policy stance to try and support growth.
Despite inflation quickening in July, the BSP forecasts inflation to be on a downtrend in August. But BSP Chief Eli Remolona Jr. also says they are open to an off-cycle action depending on the data coming in.
We're always open to off-cycle. If growth is unexpectedly weak, and then it looks like our projections of inflation and inflation expectations suggest lower inflation going forward. So pwede mag-cut.
Meanwhile, the central bank eyes an expansion of its financial education campaign for social workers, farmers, and fisher folk. In partnership with the Social Welfare and Agriculture Departments, the BSP E-Learning Academy, or BELA, will offer lessons on financial planning, budgeting, and debt management. Lessons in the modules were developed by the private sector, represented by BDO Unibank. The BSP says the e-learning modules will soon include lessons in investments and fraud protection.
Very successful yung mga ginawa nating modules. Gamified kasi siya. It's like, for them to learn FinEd. So ito, iro-roll out nila sa lahat ng, sa buong Pilipinas na, all farmers and fisher folk, not limited to BFAR and ACPC.
Lady Vicentia, ABS-CBN News.
The jobs numbers, the Philippines' unemployment rate easing for the month of June to 3.1% from 4.1% in May. That translates to 1.62 million jobless Filipino workers compared to 2.11 million jobless back in May. Meanwhile, underemployment rate climbed to 12.1%, equivalent to 6.08 million Filipinos underemployed. Now, underemployment is widely considered as an indicator of the quality of work because it refers to people who have jobs but are looking for extra work to make ends meet. More details in the breakdown later on in the show. Again, the jobless rate or unemployment rate easing, but underemployment rate rose for the month of June. This Philippine House lawmakers adopting a resolution allowing different committees to jointly investigate crimes linked to POGOs and illegal drugs. Three panels of the lower chamber are holding separate probes on illegal activities linked to POGOs, as well as on the alleged human rights violations committed during the Duterte administration's drug war. Lawmakers are also investigating illegal substances found in a Pampanga warehouse, which is owned by Chinese nationals with links to the Farmily Corporation. Senior Deputy Speaker Aurelio Gonzalez Jr. says the three issues are connected and the same resource persons may be invited to the hearings. President Marcos opened to sparing special business process outsourcing companies providing services to gambling firms affected by the blanket ban on offshore gaming operations. This is according to Philippine Gaming Regulator Chairman Alejandro Tenco, who proposed the idea to Marcos in their meeting earlier this week. Tenco told Marcos that if these BPOs are included in the ban, some 10,000 Filipinos will lose their jobs. To recall, Marcos announced in his third State of the Nation address a complete POGO ban after some were linked to crimes and human rights abuses.
Sabi naman niya, o sige, kung ganun naman, ipresenta mo ng mainam sa buong committee na yan at pagkatapos yung general plan itself na inyong mapapagkasunduan ipresenta ninyo sa akin.